scratches in the side on the brake there. Sorry about the stream there. I noticed that the stream had went down there. We are now back up and going. Tim got that first game. Tim is up 1-0 in the first race of 4. He has to beat Mark twice. Back online again. Yeah. Went down for a few minutes. Somebody must have been texting Tim, letting him know that we were offline. He must have a few viewers there watching. Thanks for watching. Sorry about being down. We are back up again. Chat page on who they think is going to win this match here, what they think the score will be. I'd have to say I'm probably biased since Tim is my teammate, so I'll have to take Tim probably a 4-2 in this first one and maybe 4-3 in the second one. Wondering what he's going to do with this 13 here coming up. So far, Tim is up one game to nothing here on Mark in the championship match. Draws back and just barely nicks that 8 and kind of buried himself here on his next shot. Not sure if he can even get the 9 there, try to cut it up in the corner or get a hit on that 9. He's going to have to lag just to get a hit here. There. Here's Mark ball in hand. He's still going to have to deal with that 8. He's tied up with that 13 also. That game there, so it's tied up at 1 apiece here. This is the first match to 4 here at the championship. Tim has to take Mark down twice. If Mark beats Tim in the first match, then it will be over. Squirrel jumper style there. Let's go. going to go with Stripes here. got there by Mark. Here's a little combo here. We'll just try to take that three and come across the rail. Takes the combo. And comes back over for a decent shot on the seven there. We'll come back off and take that eight inside. Can't foresight that there. Out there. Mark is now up 2-1. Like I said, this is a race to four. They are both A. There is no handicap in this match. Each other up a little bit there. Shoulder off. Here he comes again. Back at it. Feel free to throw a comment up on the chat and let me know how I'm doing here on announcing. Or feel free to comment and let me know on Facebook there. My name's Shane Rapp, by the way. Yeah.
Yeah.
Tim's having a little problem with his shoulder here. We're going to take about a 5-10 minute break here. Let him rest his shoulder real quick. Thanks to Mark there. You see him out there. Thank him for that. Being a good sport, giving him a break there. Let him try to put that back in place.
Anybody out there? All right, this is Kevin Kidd with Midwest Amateur Pool. Just want to let you know what's going on here. Tim broke, and he's got a problem with his shoulder popping out of place or something, and his shoulder popped out of place and kind of fell to the ground there for a second. So he's over there working on his shoulder, and I'll let you know as soon as I know anything. I would say that it's probably either going to be chopped, forfeited, or being played here within the next 5 to 10 minutes. So just hang tight here.
Sorry for that delay. Jim threw his shoulder out. Mark was nice enough there to let him take a 5-10 minute break and regroup there. Jim says he's okay. He's going to keep on going there. He has a little shoulder issue there in the past. Nothing new. And Eric... See Eric McAvoy there asking how the match is going there. Right now we are in the championship match, by the way, guys. It is Tim Rustad versus Mark Phillips in the championship match. Mark Phillips is on the hill. Tim Rustad has to beat him twice in the race to four. This is the first match, and Mark is up. Mark is up 2-1.
That's all in your case.
Tim's looks like he's just thrown a little off his game here. Hopefully he'll be able to get back into it here. Thank everybody again for watching here. Words of encouragement there in the 14-day alumni group there on Facebook.
Hey, is there?
Yeah.
I don't.
You can do it, man.
No.
Take your time. Looks like Mark here is going to go with the five there and the side. Oh, off the seven and the 13 into the side. Beautiful shot there by Mark. Well, Mark says that that shot would have went clean, so he's saying that that was a lucky shot there to go off those two balls. And I thought maybe he was trying to go off them too. And nice shot there on the one to come around with seven. Be able to take seven inside there and take eight up top here. Yep. Got to put that eight in the corner there. Yeah, nice out there by Mark. Three games to one here in a race of four for the championship. He is on the hill, so he pretty much needs one game here to end this out for first. Tim needs to run off three rags here and then bring it to another match. Been a long day of pool for both of these guys. I believe Mark had quite a long wait there to get back up to play, which is typical when you're sitting on the hill there. Nothing like being in the hot seat. Hurry up and wait. all love being there. We all hate the wait. Towards the end here, we'd like to thank the Nickel Spot here in Sioux Falls for putting on this tournament today, and the added money that they throw into these tournaments, always appreciated, to help get pool players out here to play some pool. Also want to thank Kevin Kidd there with MAP Pool for putting this on, live streaming this event here today. He will be heading up and doing another live stream event, I believe, up in Fridley, Minnesota here within, I think, 2 weeks for the next stop on the MPA Pool Tour there, Minnesota Pool Players Association, put on by John Stitch. He always runs a nice tournament up there. Also sounds like Kevin will be broadcasting or streaming live from Great Bear Casino, possibly on Thanksgiving weekend there for their singles and team tournament up for MPA up there. Want to thank all of Kevin's sponsors for helping him out too. JJ's Billiards and Keith's Cues for sure, and everybody else that sponsors and helps donate for him to put this on for us. I'd like to thank Kevin today for giving me a chance here to announce these matches for my teammate here. It's been a lot of fun. Yeah, I found myself a new future career there. Got a couple comments saying that I'm doing a pretty good job, so thanks to everybody for the comments. Olivia for the comments and the text, reminding me of a few things to mention here too. Thank you. Since I have the airtime, might as well say, hey, come check out on Thursday nights. We shoot out of Brandon Double D Saloon, the Border Jumpers. Otherwise, my team name is the Squirrel Jumpers out of Laverne League in Minnesota. Otherwise, any team tournaments, come check us out. Nice shot there by Tim. Shot there by Tim. And get this 12 up there and leave himself the 8 here and get out on this track here. There on the 12 by Tim. Left himself the 8 up there in the corner. Rattles a little bit, puts the 8 in the corner for the win. puts Mark up 3-2. Tim's break here. Stretching his shoulder as he walks around the table a little bit there, but I don't want to throw that baby out again on the break. To bring it to a second match. And Tim's down here with Frank. Resets himself here, gets back down. He takes a nice and easy this time with that hurt shoulder there. Yeah, a little bit easier in the break there. Nice break though. Couple problem balls down there. Mess down there with that foot. Well, the 4-2 looks like he combo that in, but a 6-ball with 14, there's going to be a problem for either strikes or solids. Nice shot on the 11 there, broke out that 14. Take care of that problem on the solids there. Looks like he's got table hit. Possibly a run-out table here. He's going to have to come back up at some point in time here for this 12 on the other end of the table here, though. See what his plan is there for that. Assuming here, he'll probably take the 10 and come back over for 15 and try that 9 up and follow the 9 so he can get that 12. Come up on its own, just a little hard there with the cue ball in the corner there. Almost Mark a chance here with ball in hand to try to run out and end the match here. He's got eight balls to get out here, so we all know. No matter how easy the eight balls are, they're never easy. Corner. So it gives Tim another chance at this rack here. See what Tim does here. I think the easiest play here would look like the 12 here and come off a couple rails with the 9 up in the corner and then the 8. He's looking at the ninth first here. He's thinking about drawing it or... Looks like he's lining up center of the cue ball. I'm not sure here what he's thinking for sure. Yep. Let's see here. See what he's got playing. Nope, he is looking like he's drawing it here. Trying to draw it over. Wait. I think that one's in the way there for him. Nice hit on the 12, but no rail afterwards. For any viewers that don't know, in the leagues around here, you must hit your ball and then a rail after you hit the ball. I'm sure most of you guys on here would know that. So once again, Mark here has a chance to finish out the match here. A pretty wide open looking table here, but...
Shame. Eric McMuller says, what's the status of the match?
So as long as he was listening, I told him earlier.
Is it 3-0?
It is 4-2. Or 3-2.
3-2.
Yep. Mark finishes off here, the match will be done.
Mark Phillips, gentleman shooting now, is up 3-2. Sorry about the scoreboard, guys. Been slacking.
Yeah, he's just got me here announcing, so he knew he could take some time off. Oh, Mark ends up rattling the one there in the corner. It's Tim, a tough shot here on the 12, though. He's thinking about cutting it in there, but... by the one there. I believe Mark has a shot on the one there. Yeah, Mark puts the one in the corner there. Should be able to take this four down in the corner and pop back off for the eight in the same corner. Nope, the tie's right up there against the one there, or against the eight there. Jim might have one last throughout the hook here. See if Mark can either pocket this 8 or tie Tim up to where he can't get that 12, which 12's sitting pretty close to the corner pocket there, so a pretty tough one to even try to tie him up with lagging for.
Until it's over.
Tim heading back to the table here. Mark tried a hard bank on the 8. Oh. corner. Probably wanted to pop out a little bit more for that eighth there, so you know, quite the cut there. You can get that cue ball moving just a little bit here. Let's stay out of the pocket here. We can put this one down, bring it hill-hill. Rattles in the corner and leaves Mark straight in on the edge there. Tim puts it in for him. Give Mark the match there. Well, I would like to thank everybody once again for watching us today on mappool.com there on Ustream. And go please like Kevin Kidd's Facebook page there for MAP Pool. And I'd like to give a shout out to Tor Lowry from Zero X Billiards. Thanks for the training and everything you did for me and Tim. And hopefully in next term you'll be able to see a little more of that training payoff here. And also anybody out there, go like Zero X Billiards on Facebook, like MAP Pool on Facebook, and the Nickel Spot, and JJ Billiards, and Keith's Cues, and help everybody out that helps everybody else out so we can keep this on the air. And I'd like to thank Kevin and MAP Pool again for letting me announce today. And here's to another day of pool.